Americans not only voted for a new president, they're also choosing one-third of the Senate and all of the House of Representatives. Bae Eun-ji zooms in on the developments.
It's not just the U.S. presidential election race that's tight, as those for the Senate and the House are also very close. Republicans have much of the Senate, while Democrats have the House majority. Out of the 35 seats open for election in the Senate, Democrats need a net gain of 3 to win control if Joe Biden wins the presidency, and 4 seats if Donald Trump is re-elected. Democrats are projected to have flipped 1 seat by winning in Colorado and is expected to flip in Arizona, while Republicans have picked up 1 in Alabama. But according to CBS News and CNN, it is looking increasingly unlikely that the Democrats will take the majority. This is because Maine's Susan Collins, regarded as one of the most vulnerable Republicans in the Senate, won re-election. In addition to Maine, Republicans held on to seats in Montana, Texas and Iowa that the Democrats had hoped to flip. In the House election, Democrats currently have an advantage of 32 seats, which makes a net gain of 17 needed for the Republicans to win control. As of 6 a.m. U.S. Eastern Time, Democrats took 199 seats and the Republicans 188. Each party needs to gain more than 218 seats to take the majority. Meanwhile, Marilyn Strickland became the first Korean-American woman to be elected to U.S. Congress. Strickland, who was the mayor of Tacoma, Washington, won the race in the state's 10th congressional district. Born in Seoul to a Korean mother and an African-American father, Strickland also becomes the first African-American to represent Washington in Congress. Bae Eun-ji, Arirang News.